as official. They re all being bust out as hidden rule in Trump's travel ban goes into immediate effect. It is the end of the road for liberals who have mercilessly fought tooth and nail to reverse President Donald Trump's travel ban for almost an entire year. Although they had some moments of success with the help of some crooked judges who used a loophole and abused their positions to block Trump's progress, in the end, they lost when the Supreme Court settled the fight once and for all by allowing Trump to enact his ban. However, there was a hidden detail within it that wasn't known until after. There was nothing liberals could do about it. Now, it is too late for illegals who are getting the boot as the ban has gone into full, immediate effect. The tug of war on the travel ban put the country on the brink of a civil war with the way that liberals went about making their own rules to usurp the president's. Fox News Tucker Carlson explained it best. The least accountable branch of our government becomes the most powerful, the judicial branch, and various cities and states can nullify virtually any federal law they don't like, effectively becoming their own countries, he said, before issuing a warning of what will come from this increasingly popular practice. There is a word for that, it is called civil war. We could be facing the same backlash now for a different reason after illegals have lost all the control Barack Obama had granted them for 8 years. The party is officially over since they are no longer protected for a different reason, which ICE just blindsided them with today in a brutal announcement they didn't see coming. Wayne Dupree reports. ICE will be following the law from this point forward based on the January 25 executive order of President Trump. We the people of America would like to wish all of you that have been in this country illegal good fortune as you are rounded out and shipped out. Just remember, this is not personal, this is the law. This country and Canada are really the only two countries you were allowed to get away with walking into or jumping the fence illegally and then grabbing benefits as if you were legal citizens. If you need to get angry at anyone, channel your frustrations at Democrats and their leaders. They sold you a bad bill of goods that couldn't be covered when the check came due. They are responsible for this cluster pileup and leading you down the wrong road with failed promises. Once again, our country has laws that need to be followed or we do not have a country. I am sure that each of you knows this because you left a country where you didn't like those laws only for a country where you thought you could hide out for a couple of years while sending money back home to your other family members. ICE will be following the law from this point forward based on the January 25 executive order of President Trump. If I were you, self-deport yourself quickly as you will not look good being forced on a bus or shipped out on boats. It is time for these people to go back to their own countries and make those places great again, rather than coming to America and trying to change it to be like the place they just fled from. They can fight for control of their corrupt governments and reclaim their countries. It is time for America to start watching out for the Americans and make safety and security a number one priority, not other people's sensitivities. Tucker laid it out perfectly in his previous statement. Liberals and illegals don't respect the system, checks, and balances that our forefathers set up on purpose, which was to create a government accountable to the people. The left does what they do best and found a loophole to get what they want and go around our president with these little victories, after losing the presidential victory. If conservatives had repeatedly pulled these kinds of rulings when Barack Obama was in office, we would have already experienced a civil war before now. Perhaps a civil war is what liberals want so they can blame the mutiny on Trump and pave the way to his impeachment. It is a manipulative game they are playing, from abusing power to blaming others for the issues they create. Barack Obama set a record number of executive orders in his 2 terms in office, and while Trump is well on his way, thankfully, of undoing those, the resistance from the opposing party is completely different. It is only a matter of time before we find ourselves in a civil war, considering that liberals can let that and allow Trump to simply do his job. No matter if it even hurts people in their own party.